Hello, my name is Motoyuki Ito from Nagoya University in Japan. I will talk to you about a paper published in 2003 in Developmental Cell. I was involved in this work as a postdoc in Ajay Chitney's lab at the NIH. The zebrafish mimo mutant was originally identified from the large-scale mutagenesis screening conducted in Tübingen and Boston. The phenotype of MIMO mutant was first described in 1996 in development. As you can see, MIMO mutant got bigger brain, after which the mutant was named. By positional cloning, we identified the responsible gene for MIMO mutation. MIMO turned out to be a ubiquitin ligase for delta, but it's structurally distinct from neurized. We also found the MIMBOM induces endocytosis of delta. Using in vivo transplantation assay, we found that the MIMBOM is required for mainly in signaling sending cell rather than signal receiving cell. Here's our proposed model for MIMBOM function in notch activation. First, delta binds to notch and MIMBOM ubiquitinates delta. Next, along with delta endocytosis, the extracellular domain of notch is transendocytosed into the signal sending cells. This facilitates cleavage of the notch receptors in signal receiving cells. Finally, the cleaved notch intercellular domain goes into the nucleus to activate target genes. Our analysis of MIMO function provided fresh insights into poorly understood mechanisms that are required to make delta a more effective ligand. 8 years after our publication, it's great to see the accumulating evidence suggests that MIMBOM-mediated notch ligand ubiquitination is an evolutionarily conserved process for notch activation in human, mouse, and Drosophila. Furthermore, another class of ligand jagged turned out to be a MIMBOM substrate, and MIMBOM can also make jagged an active ligand. We still have many questions unanswered. For example, when and where notch ligands become active, how it is regulated by various ubiquitin ligases. We also do not fully understand how MIMBOM enzyme activity and substrate specificity are determined. Hopefully, future research will clarify these points. Finally, I'd like to thank all collaborators who participated in this work. Thank you.